20% is erectile function, and his prostate is slightly bigger at 55cc. What would you like to offer this gentleman?
So I think we'll start in the same order. Ananda, what are your thoughts about this patient? I guess one of the issues might be the PSA, but what are your thoughts?
Again, from the acute infusion point of view, I think Urolift has gotten a bit of overhand because of the strong evidence in the form of Pulsar study, and age, no hematuria, and all those things are nicely supporting the Urolift. Having said that, with this PSA of 7.8, I'm giving worry whether the PSA is during the retention episode or due to the catheter, that needs to be careful. I will offer this patient, apart from the hysteroscopy, also an MRI, just to make sure that we don't have a quite prominent pyrite 4 or pyrite 5 areas. And if there is something like that, we will be heading towards the pathway of biopsy and the increased elevated PSA evaluation. But ignoring the PSA, I'm quite happy for him to have Urolift as long as the leading load is less than 1cc. Pulsar study has shown that the outcome of Urolift in acute retention is much better than even the patients without retention. That shows that if you really de-obstruct the channel, the patients will be having a good outcome.
But do you differentiate between these patients? They have different reservations when it is high pressure versus low pressure retention.
Yeah. Regarding high pressure, that's different, and even for non-high pressure chronic retention, that's an entirely different discussion. I will not vouch any of the discussions what we are doing today for a high pressure chronic retention. It has to be an absolute cavitary procedure like holmium enucleation or any laser enucleation, if not at least a good T or P. I don't advise it for any of the chronic retention patients also, because the chronic retention patient problem is the bladder, and by treating the prostate, you won't achieve a good contact in the bladder.